We are out here. We are out here. We live, baby. We live, baby. What up? What up? What up?
You need to X out that window again.
I do. I know. Let me X this out. Okay. All right. Hanging out. Okay. So we are here. Oh, snap. Okay, let this chat's going real quick. I love y'all too. Hey, everyone. So we are here for what we've been waiting for, okay? This discussion about hair. We got everyone. Well, I don't think everybody likes to hate him, but we got everybody hates Angel here.
So what's
Please
up?
introduce yourself to everybody who don't know you.
What's up? How y'all doing?
Now, he's not going to be showing his face. I know a lot of people have been asking me this. He's not going to show his face. Okay. He's very, very, shy. Let me stop. Who knows? You something else.
I'm not shy. You know what it is? Let me introduce myself for those of you that don't know. So my name's Angel. I have a YouTube channel called Everybody Hates Angel. They probably do. The reason for my name is that I feel sometimes I upset people, and there are people that dislike me in every little section. Doesn't matter whatever every walk of life. And I know there's people that love me and support me, but sometimes hate ain't always a bad thing because it means that you're doing something right. For those of you that are in here, I see my IKYG family in the building. I see you have you.
Yes.
And it is what it is. We talk about on our on my channels a lot of education, teaching, uplifting, self-love, knowledge. And we just came from my channel. We just did a had a conversation about mental health and mental illness over on my channel. So now, we're over here. So thank you, D Mademoiselle.
Yes, no problem, Angel. So today we're going to be talking about natural hair. Now, y'all know I talk about natural hair on my channel almost every week. Like, I just can't get away from it because this is just something that makes me so angry when people try to discriminate against natural hair or a woman with natural hair. Now, I know a lot of people are very upset by this title. And y'all already know I'm the queen of clickbait. Okay, that is clickbait. Okay, no, I do not personally think that they hijacked, stole, whatever the movement. Okay, we're going to get into that. But Angel, how do you feel about the natural hair movement in general?
The natural hair movement, I mean, it's an amazing thing. I mean, come on, think about it. Natural hair, when we're talking about black women and the versatility of black hair and how beautiful it is and how amazing it is, I think it's one of the most incredible things to push forward. It's all about acceptance, it's all about love. And I feel like this conversation is going to go into a lot of different aspects of it, especially what can I say? I love natural hair. Everyone that knows me, I love locks. I love afros. I love twists. I love cornrows. Whether you got 4C, 3C, 3B, 4Z, doesn't matter whatever you got. I love it. You know what I'm saying? So that's me. That's me. I love natural hair.
Do you think that like other men, like black men, appreciate natural hair? Because I feel like they don't. I've had people call me Brillo pad head. I had people call me Aunt Jemima. I've had people call me all types of names. So do you think that's like a thing that black men appreciate?
Here's the thing, I'm gonna go with it, all right? So sometimes black women say to me all the time, they say, do you know what? They tell me how white men appreciate their hair so much, or Asian men appreciate their hair so much. And they'll say it's black men or mixed black men that don't appreciate their hair. And I think it's very sad. And I think first and foremost, black men, we gotta do a lot better. We have to do so much better. Because there are groups of black men that will tell black women, it's almost like black women can't win sometimes. It's if you got a weave in, they'll say, oh, you got a weave, you want to be a white woman or something like that. So then you take the weave off, you cut the relaxer out, and you go natural, and then they start attacking you and saying, oh, you nappy headed this or that. And it's like, wait, hold on, you can't I can't win. Like, what's go which one is it? So first and foremost, black men, we have to do so much better. And I honestly believe a lot of black men that I know say how much they love natural hair. But the thing is, you can say you love it, but are you vocal? Are you telling black women it shouldn't be that you know, it's got to come from a white man or from an Asian man. Black men, you got to be vocal. You got to be like, damn, sis, I love your hair. Let me tell you something I did. I was on the streets one time. I saw this sister. She had these locks. They were amazing. And I went up to her just casually and I said, excuse me, miss, I just want to say your hair is incredible. It is amazing. Because that's the type of thing. That's how I feel. You know, when I see a sister with embracing her natural hair, mm-hmm. I love it. I don't, and I know, you know, I get it. Sisters, I get it. You know, you got the protective hairstyles. You know, sometimes y'all rock a wig, you know, you want to switch it up. That's the versatility and the beauty of Black women, right? Y'all could switch it up. But knowing that you got your beautiful crown underneath your head, and that's what Black men, that's what we need to push. And then you can't just, sometimes I think that some of the guys that chastise Black women, some of them are going to do it regardless. It doesn't matter what you do. You know, go natural, get permed, go bald, you know, mm-hmm. like even if you give them exactly what they want, some of these guys are just gonna, you know, they could say, listen, I want you to walk on water. So you're gonna walk on water, and they'll be like, it ain't like you ran.
That's true. So do you think, and a lot of people are in my comments talking about this, and I want to bring this up. So I know a lot of men say they like natural hair. I've come across a lot. But is it natural hair or is it a looser curl thing? Because I see a lot of people glorify, you know, the 3A, the 3B, the 3C, even the 4A, but the 4B through Z, that don't get any appreciation. Like, people be looking at my hair like, well, actually, no. I've been discriminated against my hair, but not my hair texture per se. Just I have gotten the occasional, oh, well, you know, your hair should be looser because, you know, you are lighter than, okay. you know. And I'm like, how? I think I'm really smack down in the middle. You feel me? I think I'm right there.
You know what I want to do? Mm-hmm. I want to compare the natural hair movement, right? Mm-hmm. And I want to compare natural hair for a moment to colorism. Just please bear with me, okay? So for so long, Black women were told that, dark-skinned Black women were told that light skin was better. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they were. And in some cases, you know, they're still overlooked for light-skinned women or mixed women. So when dark-skinned women are uplifted, they've got every right to have their own space and have something exclusively for them. Because the whole purpose is to encourage self-love, is to say, look, you've been degraded for so long because of your complexion, that what we're going to do now is we're going to uplift you, and we're going to say that your skin is beautiful, your dark skin, your chocolate complexion is amazing, and we want to give you something just for you. So if somebody, people come along and go, oh, you're causing division, it's like, it's not about causing division, it's about rectifying and correcting something that is an issue. Yeah, and in order by doing that, mm-hmm. you don't do that with exclusivity. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's like people say that it'll cause division, but as long as you're not chastising others that may be slightly different to you or anything like that, I don't see a problem. It's like plus size models. They've got their own thing, right? And nobody goes to plus size models and go, oh, why you don't got no skinny chicks on the catwalk? Slim models, they got their own thing. You know, you got the high fashion. They have very tall, skinny women. You know, no one says anything. But of course, they can also come together and work together on projects too. So I don't see how it's a problem if it helps correct any issues, right? Especially if it's caused by colorism. Now, of course, we're not talking about colorism, but there's an aspect of this. And I think the new word that's been coined, I think I've heard Chrissy say it, is texturism. And texture, in a way, is almost like a byproduct of colorism. Of course, there are light-skinned and mixed people that have 4C hair. I've seen it. And there are many dark-skinned sisters with very loosely curled hair. But in regards to this, it's a repeat of the whole, well, if you're going to be a Black woman, then you better be light-skinned. Or you got to be mixed to get noticed or recognition. And that's the only way you're seen as beautiful, you know, et cetera, whatever. So with the natural hair movement and these natural hair groups, something that was created to celebrate natural hair and to uplift and instill self-love in women that may have been told that their natural hair wasn't good enough because it was 4C or tightly curled or coiled. Mm-hmm. So when you see nothing but women with loose curl patterns being promoted as the epitome and the forefront of natural hair, it literally sends a message that natural hair is good, but only if it looks a certain way. Only if it isn't too curly. Only if it isn't kinky. Only if it's over a certain length. So how is that fair? That's counterproductive to the purpose. That's counterproductive to the whole reason that there was a natural hair movement.
In the first place, yeah.
Right. And this isn't to say that, like I said, that only women with 4C hair should be promoted. And that's not what I'm saying at all. But it's definitely about meaning and representation. Otherwise, we're just stuck in the whole black is beautiful, but only with certain features.
Mm-hmm.
So even, and I just want to touch with the title for a moment. Mm-hmm. And I know some people were upset about it, but it's like when they say, oh, was the natural hair movement hijacked by mixed women or whatever? Like mm-hmm. I said, the natural hair movement really, in my opinion, was for sisters that were permanent hair, relaxing their hair, rocking weaves, etc., being told that their tightly coiled kinky hair wasn't beautiful. Mm-hmm. It was supposed to say, look, to be nappy is to be happy. Mm-hmm. So most mixed women, in my experience that I saw growing up, were not permanent or relaxing their hair.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they may have straightened it and then brought it back to curly when needed. But most mixed women, in my experience, were always being told how nice their hair was. So they weren't experienced the anti-tightly curled afro mm-hmm. hair negativity or narrative. And there are mixed women with 4C hair.
There's mixed women who have gone through that type of situation. It's just not as bad as other women with kinkier type of hair.
Yes.
So but do they get excluded?
It's not that. It's when you talk about that, it's like, okay, I'm speaking. All right, look, my hair, for example. I got a whole bunch, 3A, 3B, 3C. Don't ask why I know this stuff, right?
I'm like, what you looking into that for?
hair that looks like mine, right, generally isn't, people aren't generally going, oh, look at your hair. It's so nappy. It's so thick. Like you said, oh, the Brillo pad aspect. We don't experience it like that. We don't. And it's like, we have to be real. Mixed race women and women with hair like mine or looser curls were not experiencing the same treatment or negativity based on their hair texture. It's not about being natural hair Nazis and saying only women with tight full hair allowed. Nah. It's about remembering the reason and the purpose for the movement. Otherwise, you're just saying, well, natural hair is beautiful, but only when it's loosely curled. And that completely goes against the whole purpose of the movement.
Okay, so what about girls who do have 4 type hair and they never got a perm before? Are they considered part of the natural hair movement?
Of course, because their hair is natural.
But you said something about, the natural hair movement was made for people who were perming their hair, cutting it off, blah, blah, blah.
No, it's to instill self-love for those that are not. See, the sisters there always embrace their natural hair, right?
Mm-hmm.
They're almost like the pioneers. They're the ones that say, look at me. Look at my hair. It's beautiful. I love it. Come join us.
Mm-hmm.
They're saying you don't got to add all these chemicals to your hair. You don't got to rock weave. You don't have to destroy your edges. You don't have to, all of the health issues that can come with relaxing and stuff like that. You can join us because natural hair is beautiful and it's amazing.
Yeah. I actually made a video about this before and it was so much controversy. And it was like, should white people be considered natural? Because someone asked me this question. I straight up said no. But there were people in my comment section and they were like, oh, how about girls with red hair? Because they're discriminated against, which is true. They really are. But I was like, it's not the same.
It's not
the same at all. I mean, yeah, they're called devils and witches.
It's this all lives matter crap.
Yeah, I'm like, that's their business. I don't know about that. I'm not white. I didn't grow up white, but no, they shouldn't be part of the natural hair movement. And then a lot of people were saying that if you've never had a perm.
Can I just pause this one more? Go ahead. I just want to shut this fool down. When you sent me the screenshot, this person said, I'm an intellectual, people that know that. He said, what he said about Africans, I'm a pan-Africanist, furthermore. I just want to address this person. This person is talking about a video that I made where I mentioned that biracial people and light-skinned people in South Africa are called colored. South Africans refer to biracial and light-skinned people as colored. This they do. Now, this person turns around and says, that I'm somehow lying and saying that, blaming it on Black South Africans. Black South Africans do call light-skinned and biracial people in South Africa colored. This is a fact. Whether you want to say that white people started it or white whatever, who carries something on is a fact. So you can continue with what you're saying. Please don't put words in my mouth. I'm a pan-Africanist, first and foremost.
Yeah, I hope that person's in here too. I hope that person's
they
in
are.
Here.
It's Kuma, whatever his name is, this person. Anyway. So, and if you read the comment, he said, Black South Africans are oppressing colored people and that we created that term, but in actuality, it was white people. If you actually look at what I said South Africans. And I said, and the thing about me is my receipts never lie. My receipts are there, my videos are there. So, exactly. And the people in the chat saying, well, it is true. You know, there's no lie. That's what I say, find a lie. Anyway, let's continue with the topic. And let's get back to work. Let's get back to work. All right, let's get back to work. People know me. Let's get back to work. My bad.
Okay, well, where was I? I'm a mess. Where was I?
We're talking about ginger people. People.
Yeah. There were a lot of people in there, and they said, oh, even girls who are natural, if they've been natural their whole lives, they can't be part of the natural hair movement. Then they said, if you don't have four type of hair, you can't be in the natural hair movement. I was looking at the comments. I wanted to shut my channel down. Like, I was just like, what in the?
It's about promotion, though. I mean, like, if your hair is natural, you're part of the natural hair movement, right? But it's about representation, and it's about those that are, come on. It's like, I saw, there was a, what was it, Bette Midler? I don't want to take it there on your channel. Like, Bette Midler. She wrote a post and she said, women are the N-words of the world. And it's like, look, how can you jump and try to take an oppression? How can you just want to be the victim, right? Oh, and it's like, okay, women, as a fact, right, they do struggle. They have all of these different aspects that, you know, they have to suffer and they have to be resilient and whatever. But you know who has to do it the most? Black women. Because not only are they women, they're also black. I call it a struggle within a struggle, right? Mm-hmm. So when you try to say, well, you know, we're ginger and, you know, we get called names and we get.
I was laughing so hard.
But you know what? Ginger people, they don't go to a job and somebody says to them, do you know what? I'm sorry, you can't have a job because your hair is unprofessional because it's ginger. But black people can wear cornrows, braids, locks, afros, and be told, hold up, your hair is unprofessional. That's not professional enough. This doesn't happen to ginger people. They're reaching. Everyone that has natural hair, they're part of that natural hair movement. They're embracing their natural hair. But please remember, you know, is a girl with ringlets and loose 3A hair or 2 whatever hair, is she told, oh, your hair is unprofessional. Oh, your hair is nappy and ugly. Oh,
sometimes,
I can't have no.
Yes.
I can't have no. Nah, come on, not to the level. When have you? There are rappers that say, I can't fuck with no nappy headed hoes, right? They say that.
What's the definition of nappy now? But that's the real question.
We know.
Nappy?
Listen, when someone says nappy hair, right? They're not. I don't know if people can see my, you know, my picture. They're not talking about hair that looks like mine. See, I like to reclaim the word nappy and see it as a positive,
yeah, me too.
You know, rather than a negative. I love the word nappy. I love it.
Say nigga nappy.
You know,
nappy.
Before that movie, Napoli Ever After, people that follow me on Instagram know I use that term. I said, you know, I'm gonna marry an African queen, raise African children.
I'm just playing, Napoli I'm Ever playing After. Devil's advocate for those of y'all in the comments. I was like, what the hell? Devil's advocate.
But you know what I'm saying? It's like, my hair, the only people that ever said to me, oh, your hair is messy or whatever, were white people. White people were like, oh, you need to do something with your hair. You need to cut your hair. You need to do this.
That's true.
You know, black people weren't saying that. It was like, oh, you got good hair. And even that term, good hair is healthy hair.
Ooh,
not
that
length.
term.
People confuse the term good hair with, you know, good with health and length. Like, let me tell you this. I got long hair, right? Mm-hmm. My hair ain't good hair. What? No, it's not good. It's long, but it's not good. And the reason it's not good is because it needs better. It needs to be healthy, you know, but my woman has got very, you know, tightly curled hair, probably, you know, in the 4Z range, and it's shorter than mine, but it's really healthy. She's got the good hair because
yeah, so
it's healthy.
Hair is healthy hair. Yeah.
Right. But when people were talking about my hair or girls that have hair like mine, they would talk about, oh yeah, she got that good hair. He got that good hair. This is why the movement is there to promote, to educate, to promote reality, realness. And I know, and I saw like some people that were in your chat before, you know, before we got on live, and I saw them saying, what do you mean? Mixed chicks, hijack the natural hair movement. What, we can have hair this, we can have, you know, and obviously it's the title that will get people's like, what the
that
hell?
That was the point.
But you have to understand. It's like this. It's like we can bring colorism into it.
Mm-hmm.
When women are told, oh, someone doesn't date dark-skinned black women because he thinks they're ugly or this or that. But they're told, oh, I only want a light-skinned woman. I only want a mixed woman. I only want this. I only want that. That's why colorism and people that want to fight against colorism are there. That's why there is movements to uplift dark-skinned black women. And it's the same way for the hair thing. I never thought in a million years that texturism was going to be a thing. When I heard about it, I was like, what, this is a thing?
Yeah, I heard about it too.
I thought it was a given that the natural hair movement is what it was really there for, you know? And it's not to say that girls with looser colored hair aren't part of the natural hair movement, but it's being what its purpose there. Someone said, is 4Z hair real? No, that's a joke that I have.
Yeah, that's a 4Z. People say that all the time. I don't know where that came from, but
it's a joke. I have a video called The Delusionoids, and my cousin is so for those of you that don't know, my father is Jamaican, he's a black Jamaican, and my mother is a biracial woman, but she's Puerto Rican. So she has a black Puerto Rican father and a mixed up Puerto Rican mother, right? Mm-hmm. So on my black side of the Puerto Rican side, the black Puerto Rican side, I have a cousin who's a black Puerto Rican, and he thinks he's not black, but yet he's got the most tightly curled, coiled hair, very dark skin, black features. And I said to him once, I said, how do you think you're not black? Bro, you got 4Z hair.
Yeah.
And so that's where the joke comes from. But
wait, why doesn't he think he's black?
You're Haitian. Your country, your island is on the same island as Dominicans.
Okay, you're right.
You get the point. You get it. Dominicans, yeah. Puerto Ricans, you know what it is. You could be black as midnight. You can look like Wesley Snipes. You can have the fullest lips, the broadest nose, the curliest hair, and they'll be like, duh. They'll be like, no, papi, I know black papi. It's not the same. It's not the same.
They will say that. You know how many Haitians I've heard who said black, they're not black? I'm like, you guys are the first independent black country. Like, how you sound? Oh my god, it just makes me want to pull my hair out. Like, the whole country's black. Like, what are you?
So that, you know, and that's the thing. And even on those, in those islands, like, you know, Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, I'm probably sure the same thing happens in Haiti, where there's such a, you know, there's such a hatred of like their blackness and even their natural hair. Come on, you already know how the Dominicans will go hard on pressing that hair. They go hard because they don't want to accept it. And it's beautiful. You know, it's natural hair is beautiful. Like, the kinky is beautiful. All the different, we could talk about this forever, but it's just to know about the real representation.
You're right.
And how it should be there, right. And what the purpose was for.
That's true. So do you think that like the natural hair movement is just a trend? Because as you see, now we got all of these girls out here, they going back. They permanent hair now. You know?
Really? So I didn't know that.
Oh, you didn't know that? Look it up. When you get off of this, right? Go on YouTube and type in just relax my hair, relaxing my natural 4C hair after like 10 years, or like freshly relaxed hair after 5 years, stuff like that. Always been happening. I had a whole rant about that on my channel. People were upset, but I ain't care because I was like, nah, how dare y'all? You can't sit there and do all of that nonsense and now you talk about some, oh yeah, I'm perming my hair. There's a lot of them out there like that.
Listen, ladies. You know, any of the brothers that perm their hair as well, you know, because back in the day, they used to have, way back in the day, brothers used to get something called a conk. C-O-N-K was a conk. Basically, it's a relaxer, perm the hair, and then slick it back. You know, like the Elvis Presley kind of hairdo, yeah. Like back in the day. They used to do that. So trends come and go. But here's the thing. I got a video on this, but the thing is this. Perming, relaxing your hair, one of the most unhealthiest thing you can do. They had... I believe they dug up a woman's body and it had been buried for something like 40 years. Mm-hmm. The chemical in the relaxer was still there on her skull.
That's insane.
That's how deep it had penetrated. Some of y'all would have seen, I think the documentary is called Good Hair, right? The Chris Rock documentary.
Yeah, I've heard about it, yeah.
Where they put relaxer on a soda can and it burnt a hole. Y'all putting this in your hair? So... If you want to be versatile, like I have this phrase that I say on my channel. I said it in a video. I said that black women are so versatile. They can look any type of different way, light skin, dark skin, brown skin. They can have loose curl hair, even straight hair, curly hair. I say black women's slogan should be, you want it, we got it. Because you don't gotta go anywhere but with black women, because any type that you want is gonna be right there. Right?
Yes, you're right.
Black women, if you want to be versatile, if you want to rock your hair straight, nobody can't tell you what to do with your hair, how to wear it, what style you're going to have. If you want to rock a straight wig, rock a straight wig. If you want to rock a curly wig, you want to rock some Diana Ross vibe, you want to do a big afro locks, do whatever you got to do. But stay away from permanent, stay away from relaxers, because I really feel that all of that push to put chemicals in your hair and stuff like that, that's a whole different type of agenda that is not healthy. And I don't want to get into that on your channel, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's a whole hour.
That's a whole different agenda, but
that's
I didn't know that women were reversing for, you know, going, you know,
it's a whole thing, Angel. You'd be surprised. It's
I don't understand why it would be necessary.
Well, I think a lot of them are doing it for views. And I actually made a video faking it, and it's so many, you know how many subscribers I lost because people refuse to watch videos? It's ridiculous. But I did it, if you see, I think it's called I Permed My Natural 4C Hair. I made it and I did the thumbnail. I put like, I put conditioner in my hair and people thought it was a perm. And I went off. I was like, are y'all dumb? Y'all putting cream and crack in your head? Like, I went in. Like, it was just so funny because I was just like, are y'all serious? It's like a real thing. A lot of girls who've been natural for years are doing this. So it's a real thing. Look it up when you get off this live. But like, do you think that like natural hair is like more accepted for men than it is women? Because I feel like women, I feel like unless your hair is loose, it's not accepted, to be completely honest with you.
You have to remember with a lot of men, their hair is short. Mm-hmm. So men will keep their hair short. So I've had long hair since forever. Right, since I can remember. I went to a job interview and I had my hair pulled back in one, so a ponytail, you got the afro puff in the back, right? Mm-hmm. Went to the interview, and at the end of the interview, the woman says to me, Angel, great interview, but do you ever wear your hair differently? And I was like, different? How do you mean? She said, she was like tripping over her words, so that you can't see the back. I said, the back? I said, it's in a ponytail. She goes, do you ever wear it in a bun? I said, a bun. I said, that's like what I got it in right now. It's a pony. She went, basically, our clients, they're a little bit traditional. Now, what she meant was her clients were racist. What she meant was this. This is what she meant. There's this whole subtle, what I call subtle racism, you know, where they don't want to necessarily say it's because you're black or it's because you're skin. They want to say it's because of your hair texture. So they say it's not professional. So what she wanted me to do was to slick my hair back as it was, but get my ponytail and wrap it in a really, really tight bun so you couldn't see the texture, so that I became almost racially ambiguous, right? Ooh. So the next day I do that for the second interview, and she says, oh my God, you look so much better, so much more professional. I literally didn't look different at all. I looked exactly the same. Now, what I did and what I noticed is when we talk about, is it more accepting for black men to be natural? Most black men don't have long hair. Their hair is going to be short. They have a fade. They got a Caesar. So they don't have to go through necessarily the stuff that happens by having long hair. I know brothers that work with that have long locks.
Oh, okay.
You know, they have long locks, and in a professional setting, they're told, oh, that's not professional.
So what about the boys with the high tops and stuff? Like, you know how now that's a new thing where boys be having the hair in the middle of their head instead of, you know, like
this again goes down to the difference for when black men, even though they're natural, they have their hair short versus having longer length. When you've got length and all of a sudden they say, oh, your hair's not professional. Oh, it's not this, it's not that. But it is more acceptable for men than women, but it shouldn't be. And I honestly feel that, especially when we talk about natural hair being accepted in the workplace, I think that comes to a part where we as ourselves, this is something that we need to address and deal with and let them know we're not going to stand for that. And we're going to treat hair discrimination as seriously as we take skin discrimination in the workplace.
Yeah, that's true. So do you think, and I've said this numerous times in my videos, I'm like, okay, so if you sit there and you complain like, oh my God, they're discriminating against me, against my hair, and then you sit there, you go get a perm, or you sit there, you go get a straight weave, and you're wearing straight weave 24/7, does that, I always said that is causing more of an issue because you're not standing for what you believe in. And then, you know, there was people that were like, oh, but I can't afford to lose my job. And I'm like, yeah, I completely understand that, but you can't sit there and complain either. It's like, no. You gotta pick one.
Do you know what that is? That's called cultural assimilation.
Yeah.
Okay. That's assimilation. The society that we live in, when you have European society and the European beauty standards, they force black people in a position where they have to do things that they don't necessarily want to do, simply because if I don't perm my hair or have my hair in this style, I'm going to lose my job. You know, and if I stand up for my rights and I do this and I, God, they in South Africa, I don't know if people saw, there was a whole story where.
You see, that's why they think you hate Africans, Angel. You better.
No, I just told the truth. I told the truth. There was the girls, there was these teenage girls in the school that wore their hair natural and afros. Yeah. And I think the principal, either the principal expelled them or chastised them because they had natural hair and said, you can't wear your hair like that in school. Like, what?
Yeah.
These are the things that are happening.
A lot of
these are the things that are happening. So it's not a case of saying, oh, do you know what? Well, you know, just stand up for your rights and do this.
So how do you think you fix that?
Let them know that in aspect, it is to let them know that we won't stand for that. And we are seeing it as an exact form of racial discrimination because it is. It's a physical characteristic that you're discriminating us against. And in the same format, we need more Black businesses. We need we need more Black owners that are understanding. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're a Black business, I work for a Black owned company. I can wear my hair in an afro. I can wear cornrows. I can put my hair in two big bunches if I wanted to. You know, sisters come in with their hair wrapped up. Sisters rock locks. They have their afros out. Do you know why? Because we're all from the same culture. We don't have to culturally assimilate to a culture that is not our own, that discriminates us simply because of our physical characteristics.
Yeah, I said that in my video too. I was like, y'all better go work for Black businesses. You better create your own business. You better do something. I had said that. I was like, listen, y'all need to stop because we need to do something because it gets me mad. Like I was telling a story about how one of my professors told me not to wear my afro to class. And I definitely went in an afro every single day, even though my hair broke off from doing that. I went every single day with my afro. Like she was Black. It was a Black lady telling me not to come into her class with an afro. Mm. So it was just like, lady, like I'm still going to come in here with my afro. That's definitely what I'm going to do. So it's just like, it's very interesting to think about like all of these people who discriminate against you. And a lot of times, and I've said this numerous times on my channel, it seems to be your very own. So what do you think about that? Like when Black people discriminate against their own kind for their hair?
You have to understand that we're in a system where there was a lot of brainwashing. There's been a process. We were taught to hate our features. We were taught to hate our skin. We were taught to hate our hair. Mm-hmm. We were told that if your skin is darker than a paper bag, that you're not going to get on in society. We were told that if your hair is too curly, that you're not going to get on in society. And we were told that we have to do extreme measures. We have to put chemicals that can essentially kill us, cause thyroids, cause cancer in order to straighten our hair so that we can just live a normal life. We talk about equality, but it's not equality because the only way that we're even treated remotely like human beings is if we force ourselves to change and assimilate to their society. This has happened so over centuries that it's so deep rooted within us. Some of us, we don't even realize that we're perpetuating all of these ideas. And
yes, that's the word that I wanted. Yes, perpetuating. Yes, go ahead.
We don't realize that we're doing it. You know, I should look at my sisters and say, when someone says to me, what do you look for in a woman? I should be saying something within my race. I should be saying, afro, thick curly hair, beautiful skin, melanated, full lips. I should be saying these things. The first thing that comes out of my mouth shouldn't be like, yeah, long straight hair and really straight, or hair like this, or hair that's wavy. And before people start with the argument, oh, but East Africans have straight hair, or some people have wavier. Yes, we know this. We know this. But we're just saying, when we're talking about people that don't, you know? And especially with women in general, women want to be seen as beautiful. They want to be seen as sexy, all right? Mm-hmm. And if women are told, you're not sexy unless your hair's straight, you're not sexy unless you're light-skinned, you're not this, you're not that, and the society is telling them, well, you can't get a job unless you do this, you see all the different factors that are going to contribute to further self-hate, to further bullying and body dysmorphic disorder. It's all going to be extra factors.
That's true.
We have to, it's all about re-educating the mind. I would say it's about teaching the children from the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, so let the kids know, yo, your hair is beautiful. Your hair is amazing. I love it. Regardless of the texture of their hair, because then they grow up. They're going to grow up and they're going to love it. And they're going to be the difference. It might not happen in my lifetime, but in the next couple of generations, if you instill so much self-love in these younger children and education and knowledge yourself, trust me, I'm a pro-black militant. People know me. Like, I want my kids to be little pro-black militants that love their skin, love their hair, mm-hmm. and you can't tell them nothing. And the day that you turn around to them and say, your hair is not professional, you can't work here, my kids are going to turn around to them and say, yeah, screw you too. I'm going to go work for either myself mm-hmm. or a black-owned company because I don't need you.
Exactly. That's exactly how I want my kids to be too, because I can't do. Like, I don't think I've ever not gotten a job because of my hair, because I've gotten almost every single job that I went to on an interview. And if I didn't get it, it was more so like I know I effed up that interview, which is probably like two jobs. But all the time I get offers all day. So it's just like, and I go in there with my afro. So it's just like, but when it comes to school and like other stuff like that, it's just like, why does it matter that my hair isn't an afro? I personally don't understand, but I definitely have gotten comments, especially from a lot of, you know, mixed girls, you know, they'll be like, oh, you know, I think you should perm your hair. You should get a texturizer. Oh, I didn't even know people still use those things. I've gotten the whole, oh, you know, you should watch some YouTube tutorials. First of all, YouTube hair gurus get on my absolute nerves. I can't do. And it just seems to me that the only ones that seem to do well, or the ones that do better than everyone else, are the ones that are either mixed or have looser textured hair. That just seems to be what it is.
That's their self-entitlement, though. The fact that they feel confident enough to come up to you and tell you what you should do with the hair that grows naturally out of your head is very telling.
Yeah, they do it. They do it all the time. And I just be sitting there like, but did I ask you for a comb? Like, I didn't ask you to do my hair. So it's just like, I don't understand what the problem is. Like, they do it all the time. So it's like, do you think that they're on a pedestal, like, you know, mixed girls and lighter skinned girls, do you think that they're on a pedestal when it comes to being natural? Do you think they're on a pedestal? And who do you think put them on that pedestal?
It's our fault. It's men. It's our fault.
Oh, okay. God. It is men's
fault. You know what? European beauty standards is the first aspect. Mm-hmm. You know, white people, Europeans tell you what's beautiful, you know, and then they tell you, oh, actually, certain features on black women are beautiful, but only in this regard, like lips are nice. Well, they'll pick and choose the things that they like. Oh, the booty is nice. So the hips are nice. So complex, you know, a tan is nice, but not too dark. They start telling you that. Mm-hmm. Then they start saying, oh yeah, we love the thickness and the curls of the hair, but not too curly. And then as black men and even mixed black men, we come along and we start saying, oh, only light skin, or only want curly hair or wavy hair or this like that. And we put them on this pedestal. We do it. You know, it is what it is. We're the ones that do that. Ladies, let me tell you something. There, you can type in right now into YouTube, just gonna let you know how amazing your hair is, right? White women think you are a costume. You know this.
Yeah.
There are videos of white women. You can type it in tutorial, something like how to turn straight hair into afro. They get like bobby pins or whatever, and they weave their straight hair in and out, in and out, in and out, so it's like zigzaggy. They close the bobby pin, they leave, you know, it's they section their hair off while it's wet, then they leave it to dry overnight, and the next day they take it out and they got an afro, straight up afro, comb it out, and they're like, oh look, yeah. There was a woman that did a video like that, and she said, yeah, sometimes I like to do this when I like a change, or some, you know, for Halloween this would be great. She said for Halloween this would be great. Can you believe that? When you realize
what,
and you got Asian boys, there's videos of Asian boys turning straight hair to afros, and they have their own little technique to turn to afros.
You need to send this to me because I want to react to this on my channel because I want to see it.
When you know how incredible, it's almost like everybody else seems to know how great we are, but us. You know, and I don't mean when I say that like, oh, they think we're great. They think things about us are great. You know what they say, everybody want to be black. Nobody really wants to be black. Yep. They like our features. Okay. They want to steal the features. They want to utilize these things while at the same time telling us, oh, no, you can't wear your hair like that. No, you don't want to be too dark. No, you don't want to stay in the sun. You don't want to have your lip. You know, all of these things. It's the most irritating thing ever. I just want black people to love their features, their hair, not look for validation from other people. The only validation black women need, listen, black women, let me tell you this right now. I'm on here right now, right? I don't need to be on here. Do you know why I don't need to be on here? You don't need to listen to a word I'm saying. You don't need my validation at all. My word means nothing. My validation means nothing. The only thing you need to hear is your own validation. The Mademoiselle is the only person you need to listen to about hair, because that's a Black woman. She can speak about her hair. She can speak about these things. You know, what I do is I listen, I observe, I pay attention, and I speak to brothers. I'm actually talking to Black men. I'm telling Black men what we need to do better. You don't need our validation at all. Black women, you got to look at yourself in the mirror and just say, hold on. Why are all these white women getting their lips done? Why are all these people doing tutorials and have to turn straight hair afro? Why are all these people killing themselves, getting skin cancer, trying to have darker skin? Why are they getting butt implants? Why are they doing this? Why are they doing it? Damn, girl, you got to say, damn, girl, we the shit. That's it. You know, listen, you know, they always say, always imitated, never duplicated.
Yes.
You know, there never going to be another you. You can try to imitate the crown, but you will never take the throne.
Yeah.
Y'all are the queens. Oh, let's be real.
Thank you, Angel. Yes. This was right. This is the truth. Y'all better go subscribe to Angel. Y'all better go subscribe. I swear to you, yo.
People were asking, they were saying, what's my channel name? My channel name is Everybody Hates Angel.
Yes, and it's in the description.
Yes, in the description. I do have an Instagram. It's called Angel_IKYG.
In the description box. Y'all better, yo, Angel be, ooh, he be taking my wig every time he talks. I be like, yes! Everything he says is gold, okay? Everything he says, okay? If you're not already subscribed, then I don't know what you've been, what have you been waiting for? Like all my Haitians especially, y'all better go subscribe, okay? If any of y'all don't like Angel, then you're crazy. Okay, there's no reason.
That's cool. I love the ones that don't like me. That's why I know you. Everybody hates Angel.
I know you do, which is ridiculous.
I embrace it.
I can't deal. You should change your name. Nobody hates you.
Okay? Nah, I'm good. I'm good.
Nobody hates you.
And you know what? On my channel, for those of you that are going to say, does he ever show his face? Yes, I have videos where I show my face. Yeah. There are videos where I show my face. Don't worry.
He's cute.
I'm not.
Yo, y'all. Y'all see that little, Avi, okay? He's decent looking, guys. So y'all better go subscribe. This was a great conversation.
Oh, I want to answer. Someone said, is Angel Black, though? All right. I'll answer this. No, because people ask the question. All right. A lot of people think, and you've seen the post on the private Instagram, a lot of people think I'm biracial. They think I'm half Black, half white, all right? Mm-hmm. And they make an assumption, all right? My mother, she's biracial. She's half Black, half Native American. Her family are Puerto Rican. You know Puerto Rican's not a race. My father's Black, he's Jamaican. Both his parents are Black. I'm 3/4 Black, 1/4 some other shit, right? There you mm-hmm. go. You make your own decision on what I am. It is what it is.
There you go. If you think he's Black, he black. If you don't think he's not, I don't have time. I've been told I'm not Black because I'm Haitian. So.
But when I'm from 3/4 Black, that's quite Black.
Yeah, you know? That's what I would consider. I would even consider most, well, not all, but some biracial people Black as well, depending on who it is.
Oh, that's another conversation for another day.
Yeah, that is a whole other story. It all depends. I think it's subjective, though, because not everyone who's mixed is Black. So, yes. I think you Black, a sexy Black man. Yo, these comments are hilarious. I can't do it, y'all. You see, y'all can't be harassing a man like this on my live. Well, that's it for this live, okay? This is over. Thank you guys so much for watching, okay? Make sure you go subscribe to Angel. Subscribe, okay? It is down in the description box. Go follow him on Twitter. Go follow him on Instagram. Do all that. Next upload is going to be tomorrow. I got a reaction hitting for y'all. Okay, I think. Don't hold me to it. I'm lazy. All right, watch my latest video. It was posted earlier today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, y'all.
Peace, love, and coconut oil.
Like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm going to see y'all next time.